Copilot just got an upgrade. Now it's available inside OneDrive. Here I have four files. Without opening the files, I ask Copilot, tell me the total amount, and it tells me. So let's learn seven different ways of using Copilot inside OneDrive. Who has it? How will you get it? Of course, you need Copilot paid version. If you have that, go to OneDrive on browser and there you will find it. As of August 2024, it is still getting rolled out. So you may not see it today, maybe in a few days. Where do you see the button called Copilot? Go to OneDrive. Hover means take the mouse cursor on any file. You should see Copilot icon. Then you'll see icon or menu on the top. In either case, there are multiple options. So let's see the first way of using Copilot. There's a Word file. Select. Open the drop down and say summarize. And then it'll show you the summary. Also remember, many types of files are supported. TXT, PDF, and even HTML. Now let's move on to the second way of interacting. Ask anything about the file without opening the file. This is an Excel file containing feedback information. I'm going to ask, what is the commonest negative feedback? I did not specify which column to go to. It figured it out and it's giving me concise output. The next method available is FAQ, frequently asked questions. So this is a proposal I sent to customers, and obviously they will have questions. So why not keep an FAQ document ready and send it along? So ask Copilot and it'll do it instantly for you. The next scenario is comparison. I have multiple versions of an agreement. One of them is PDF. I'm going to select all of them and ask Copilot to compare. Copilot drop down, compare files. Now there's going to be a complex table. So it is trying to show me all the contents, but it's not going to be visible here. So let it do its job. I'm going to copy it, paste it in Excel and format it properly. We can use the ask a question option to open the regular Copilot pane. So now I'm going to ask it a question which cuts across all files. And there you have it. This has gone through around 500 rows across four files and given us the output. Here is another question. I'm asking how many people have given rating. It gives me the count, and then I ask for an average and gives you that as well. This is really a game changer. Here is another very useful thing. I'm going to share this file with someone. I'm sending it as a link, but they don't know what is there. So why not ask Copilot to generate a summary? In few seconds, it'll create a concise overview of the file. So even if nobody clicks on it, at least they know the crux, or better still, looking at it, they'll be more prone to open the file. Let's look at a mind-boggling scenario where multiple documents are going to be correlated. I have two JDs, one for project manager and one for animation design. And then I have four CVs. I have selected one JD, project manager, and all the four CVs. And now I'm going to ask OneDrive Copilot to just figure it out. Look at the prompt. Tell me one best candidate and give me a table explaining why you did it with a rating. That's it. No further detail and look at the output. It's amazing. And to make it even more complex, I'm just going to switch the CV. People remain the same, but the job has changed. Same prompt and look at the output. So where is this available? In OneDrive Web. Inside Teams app, there is a OneDrive app. Three dots, OneDrive. This is available across many languages, not just English. And this list keeps growing. Look at the link to have the latest info. So now you know seven methods of using OneDrive Copilot. Try it out and let me know your feedback. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.